Hey, I'm here for the final round of the daily on the draw against Brian Bronduin. My hand's very pretty, but I can't keep no lands. I am on the draw and I have Gataxian Probe. If I were guaranteed to draw land, I would definitely keep, but it's not worth the risk. I'll top a land. I have Brainstorm, so if I do end up getting flooded, I can get rid of it. I think that playing Delver is better than playing Deathrite. And also this way, I get to brainstorm next turn and then get the black source with Delta and play Deathrite. If I were to play Deathrite turn one, that would use up my fetch land to go with my brainstorm. There's Plow. PBD tends to play Miracles. Let's probe, see if I need a counterspell or anything. Right, brainstorm, judgment, counterspell, entreat, strand. His hand is pretty clunky besides the brainstorm, so that's pretty important. I'd really like to find a wasteland. So I'm gonna fire off another probe. Daze is something. All right, I'm gonna get rid of the bolt and extra land. I can't interrupt this brainstorm. I did try though. There it is. I could have Daze just to force him to crack the fetch, but it's too bad if he draws another fetch. Alright, he's probably gonna get rid of. He already had another fetch anyway. He's gonna get rid of Entreat. Probably keep Council's Judgment and Counterspell. Alright, there's Force of Will. Start off with Ponder. Young Jeezy is there. And Lightning Bolt. I'll take Young Jeezy. And I have two counter spells up. I put up my counter spell, I can Daze and then replay my land. It's pretty nice. Most of the time, Daze sets you back a land, but in this scenario, it might give me an extra mana. And the top cards in my library are pretty bad, so I'm going to shuffle those away right now. Gormag Angler is good, and Lightning Bolt is good. Lightning Bolt's pretty bad. And then Negrency is awful, so I'm gonna shuffle. Ooh, Daze was actually might be the best draw in my deck, other than Gataxian Probe into Daze. Now I have two counters up. Brainstorm. That's pretty annoying if he puts Terminus back on top of his library, but I don't feel like forcing that. Right, at this point, the only card that I know about is Council's Judgment. I'm fine with that getting plowed. I still have some pressure. I have 3 damage a turn. And I can force something later. I'm not going to force the top. A lot of people do force tops. It's not really my style. Alright, Deathrite is okay. I'm not going to play it. It doesn't really do anything, but. Let's back up. I could brainstorm, but I'm gonna wait one more turn. See what I can get. If my opponent cancels judgments, that's fine. I'll just let my death rite die, and then I can replay. I can play a second one. Let's get rid of the plow and the brainstorms are doubles. I'll get rid of a plow. Then maybe I can death rite the other plow before we draw a Snapcaster. I'm happy to just do a few points of damage every turn. I'm still not going to play the brainstorm because the game is going fine for me. I'm not really in need of anything. Looks like he hit a miracle and treat. See how much he plays this for. For two. All right, I'm gonna force that pitching days. Gonna fetch my upkeep, probably playing around Stifle. Don't really want to brainstorm, but I think I have to. I'm starting to feel a little bit behind now that my force is gone. Alright, I've drew a bunch of extra fetches. Not going to play Delver, I have plenty of pressure right now. I have 3 points a turn, and my opponent's already used 2 plows and a Council's Judgment, so they probably have a bunch of Wraths in their deck. Alright, I'm going to let them resolve the top before I activate my Death Rite, but I am going to target Swords to Plowshares. Alright, I got my point down to 10. Every hit is good, because I have 5 bolts left in my deck. Jace, probably gonna bounce my elemental. Nope, just drawing. It's interesting. Maybe setting up a Terminus. I'm happy to draw a probe. It'll give me a little bit of information. But the top of his library is really interesting, too. That's where you might hide a Terminus. This game is pretty close, but I do feel slightly behind. I could certainly win if he hits a bunch of clunky cards. Alright, Force and a Ponder. Pretty good. Alright, I'm gonna chain lightning him, see what he does. Alright, my opponent did force. Let's see. I could attack down to 8, death rate my opponent down to 6, and then play probably a Gurmag Angler. Then if my opponent doesn't have Terminus, they're still not gonna die, but then I can get them down to 3. I can attack Jace for 2. It's also pretty bad. Guess I'm just gonna get Terminus and the Jace is still alive. I'm just gonna go for the face. I think my best chance of winning is if my opponent has like four blanks on the top of their library. Alright, he did draw Terminus. Really bad for me. Let's see how long it takes my opponent to assemble countertop. Until then, I can hope to draw two bolts. Alright. Young GZ. Got counterspelled. And Delver. This game is going very poorly. I'm almost dead. All right. I needed, like, my opponent to draw one more bad card and for me to draw one more good card for me to win. They haven't drawn a counterbalance yet, so I feel that it's coming soon. There's counterbalance top. I'm about to concede. Alright, I'm done with this game. Can't win. It's pretty close to winning at one point, but not quite. Sulfuric Vortex is great. I'm gonna bring in Vision, Pyroblast, Pithing Needle for sure, and Cabal Therapy. Price progress, pretty bad. They're gonna fetch basics most games. Alright, so that's seven cards. And I'll take out all of my burn spells. And the last card that I could cut is either Gurmag Angler or Cabal Therapy. Alright, I'll cut. It's tough to decide if I want one fewer threat or one fewer disruption spell. Alright, I'll cut an angler. Play with this. Alright, I'm on the play for game two. My hand is good. I'll keep. I don't have a Delver or Deathrite, but I'm going to suspend Ancestral on turn one. No reason to play the Probe. There's nothing that I'd rather play more than Ancestral on turn one. Ancestral is really bad against counterbalance because its mana cost is zero, so any land counters it. I guess I could have boarded out one Wasteland because he's probably going to play around it. Maybe I'll do that for game three if I win this game. Board out one Waste. Hmm. Gonna start off with brainstorm. Pardon me, with probe right before brainstorm. Yeah, let's look at the chat. Okay, chose to shuffle and has no lands. Brainstorm, ponder, balance, times two, chase, mentor, and treat. Let's play Death Rite and Delta. I'm gonna daze any cantrip that my opponent plays, try to keep them off lands for a little bit. Brainstorm, I will daze that. Alright, Ancestral's gonna go down to two at this point. Let's brainstorm. We can get rid of Wasteland, it's pretty bad, and the second Death Rite's pretty bad as well. I should have pondered before I decide whether or not to attack with Death Rite. I might hold up Pyroblast or Cabal Therapy on my opponent or something. But if I miss, I'd rather attack for one. Young Jeezy and a bunch of lands. I'll shuffle that. Alright, Cabal Therapy, perfect. Let's get rid of my Delta. And I'm gonna Cabal Therapy my opponent. So I could get two counterbalances or take the ponder. I think what I'll do is just take counterbalance. I have Ancestral coming, so I'll take this 2-for-1 that I can get for sure. Okay, the balances are gonna go, and then my opponent has true plow. All right, I'm gonna keep the probe to go with my force. Ponder, I'll daze that. So my opponent has Plow, Chase, Mentor, and Entreat. Wow, my opponent had a land, but didn't want to play around daze. Alright, my opponent cannot cast a single card in their hand. And I don't even want to take any of them with Cabal Therapy. No reason to brainstorm either. Let's just pass the turn. I can brainstorm once I vision. If my opponent top decks a counterbalance, I'll just force it, probably. Ugh, I didn't want that to happen. All right, I'm gonna brainstorm. I have one Pyroblast in my deck, but I wanna use Death Rite if I... I keep getting punished for all these small decisions that I make. Alright, well, I made choices and I have to pay their costs. I only had one Pyroblast my deck. If I had two like normal, I probably would have done it the other way. I'm still doing okay in this game. My opponent doesn't really have anything going on. I don't really have much going on either. I'm gonna sack this Death Rite to Cabal Therapy my opponent. I'm gonna take Monastery Mentor, leave my opponent with Plow as a castable card. Alright, my opponent's probably gonna plow me now. And then it's their two cards against my four. Alright, I'm gonna pass the turn. Wait one turn before I brainstorm. Alright, my opponent was probably just go for Jace because I've made it apparent that I don't have Daze. Alright, my opponent's down to just Entreat, which is really hard to cast. I think it costs triple white. Think that they are more Pyromancers. Yeah, slightly more Pyromancers than Deathrites and Gurmagiggler, so I'll tap the black source. Get rid of Wasteland and leave Ponder on top. Alright, now I'm back into a winning position. I almost fumbled in the middle of the game, but I think I'm going to win at this point. Terminus, it's a good draw for my opponent, but gonna force it. Gonna ponder, probably shuffle because there's one bad card. Yep, don't want that. Probe is a great draw. My life total is irrelevant, so it's just make elemental and draw a card. Going to brainstorm. Get rid of Wasteland and Deathrite. No reason to play Delver. I've pretty big clock anyway. I have a two turn clock without it. Brainstorm was a very good draw for my opponent. Probably putting the Entreat back. Ponder, probably gonna shuffle it away. Yep, does choose to shuffle. So the Entreat won't be miracle, it's just been shuffled away. Gonna get second red because I do have Sulfuric Vortex. No reason to play either of these because my opponent could Terminus, but at least if they do Terminus, I have two threats that I can replay the next turn. Okay. My opponent has got very lucky, but I can still try my best to win. Alright. Flusterstorm is decent draw. Some interaction. Gonna play both because my opponent's gone through two Terminuses, so I want to have a threat if they just play a single target removal spell like Plow. Snapcaster. I'll certainly Flusterstorm this Brainstorm. Alright. That Brainstorm is healthily been countered four times over. Alright, there's Volcanic. No reason to wasteland it in the end step. I see a lot of people do that. Might as well get the most info that I can before I use it. No reason to attack with my Delver, it'll just get blocked. Think my opponent would have used the Snapcaster while my Deathrite was summoning sick, so I'm gonna get this plow before my opponent draws one. Alright, that worked. Looks like my opponent's playing a four Ponder version of Miracles. I do encourage that. Ponder is really good. It's almost as good as Brainstorm. Okay, my opponent did shuffle. Alright, so there's a chance that I win just this turn. Really weird that my opponent attacked, didn't stay back. Alright, Mentor. That would explain it. Gurmag Angler. Worst draw in my deck. Alright. Just gonna use the death rate right now. Alright, now the death rate is lethal, and if the Delver flips, then it's lethal. Hopefully I don't have to chump block the Mentor. Alright. Won that game. I'm gonna board out a Wasteland. Maybe I'll board out two Wastelands. Because the games go pretty long, and my opponent plays around it so aggressively. So conservatively. I want to also board in Bolts because they have Snapcaster and Mentor. Multiple Mentors that I saw. I like Flusterstorm because he has Ponder. It's pretty likely to be able to hit something. These. Alright, I'll submit this. I could cut Vortex because he has creatures and could maybe race me, but I still like it. His hand's very good. As long as my opponent doesn't have top into counterbalance, it'll be pretty good. I want to save the probe until I can have Young Pyromancer into play. I might not have that luxury though. Alright, Delver is a good draw. I'll just play that. I'm not going to use the probe. Plow? I'm completely fine with that. I have plenty of creatures. Alright, another young peasy. Opponent brainstorms in response to young peasy. And, it's possible that they set up a terminus. So maybe I should save the probe to go with my next young pyromancer. I'm going to try experimental play. I'll just let this young pyromancer die. And then I'll use probe to go with the next one. Alright, turns out he didn't have Terminus. If he plays Counterbalance, I probably just lose. Alright, going for Snapcaster on Plow. I'm gonna let that happen because I have a bunch more Pyromancers. And the Snapcaster really doesn't matter. I have Cabal Therapies, and I have Pyroblast, and I have Wasteland, so I'm not really sure what the best way to cast my Young Pyromancer is. Alright, my opponent did have Counterbalance, didn't go for it. I'm glad that that didn't happen. I need to find Force. Wasteland, something. Second Days. Let's shuffle that. Alright. That ended up pretty poorly. It would have been great if I got to play Young Pyromancer into Cabal Therapy that turn. I'd just get rid of Counterbalance and Jace. Be in pretty good position. Or probably Counterbalance and Ponder, actually. Now I do not feel very safe. Alright. Back to being safe because my opponent's going to Terminus. Then I can counterbalance this turn. Unless my opponent tops into a land. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna have to play both my creatures. Because of Jace. One creature cannot beat Jace by itself. Wasteland would have been good this game, but I did board out too. sort of got punished for every decision I made. I'm still slightly in the game though. My opponent only has one card in hand, it's a Jace. Maybe I'll draw Cabal Therapy, Wasteland, Pyroblast. Brainstorm or Ponder would be a great draw. Alright, no land for my opponent. That was an awful draw. My opponent will probably continue to play around Daze and Spell Pierce, so I have that going for me. But I'm going to need to draw something soon. Sulfuric Vortex would be a good draw. That's something that's hard to answer. Alright. I have to draw Gurmag Angler or Sulfuric Vortex, something that's hard to answer. Gonna fetch because my cantrips are dead at this point, so I just want to thin my deck. Alright, gonna pretend that I have a hard cast force. Whew. Close to being dead at this point. Very, very close to being dead. Hang on by a shred. Let's get rid of Ponder. Ponder is better than Brainstorm when they have top. Is there any reason to play Deathrite? It could maybe slow down my opponent. So likely that they have one drops though. If they don't have lands, they probably have one drops. I think that I'll save it to maybe play multiple spells in one turn or something. Let's see if he floated a 2 on top or not. See how advanced his play is. Nope, just countered. Now I know none of the cards. Maybe he floated a 5 on top. Blue Delta has nothing to find. I'm gonna play Deathrite. It's just a bluff. Hope that he doesn't use the top. Just bluffing that I have something to use later. Alright, I don't. You got me. My opponent never kills the Deathrite. I will eventually kill my opponent. Alright, I'm just gonna do it again. Pretend that I have something. Another top. If there's any chance that it like slowed my opponent down or that I got it into play, I think it's worth it. It's not going to do anything in my hand. I wish I had boarded in Price of Progress just as a way to mize. I do still have Sulfuric Vortex as like the one card in my deck that I could maybe cast. Alright, my opponent's gonna play for two. I'm losing this race by the looks of it. Force was a little bit late. I could have used that last turn. I don't know if I could win, but the game is going to end pretty soon, so I'll fight it out. I got so unlucky in this match overall, just every single game, but it's okay. It's bound to happen. I could use the death threat to gain life. If I feel like it. I didn't really see any reason to play Delver. All right, so this turn I go down to five. I can put my opponent down to three, then one, then I die. So I'm gonna gain life. That way I go to seven. And this way it's still possible that I can win. All right, no longer possible. All right, I was defeated. Thank you for watching.